So hello everyone, welcome to this video tutorial on discrete versus continuous attributes. So in the last video we have seen the different types of attribute, which are nominal, ordinal, ratio and interval. So these are the types which can be described by the number of values that the attributes are taking. Okay, so it's an independent way of distinguishing between attributes is by the number of values they can take. So there are two types of attributes, size attributes. The first one is known as the discrete attributes and second one is known as the continuous attribute. Okay, so in case of a discrete attribute, has a finite or countably infinite set of values. Okay, so such attribute can be categorical, such as the zip code, okay, or ID numbers, or numeric such as suppose any count. Okay, and discrete attributes are often represented as integer variables. Okay, and binary attributes are special case of discrete attribute and assumes only two values, which may be true and false, yes or no, 0 or 1, like this. So generally binary attributes are often represented as boolean variables or as an integer variable that has only take the values 0 or 1. The second attribute, which is known as the continuous attribute, continuous attribute can take values that are real numbers. So example may include attributes such as temperature, height and weight. Okay, continuous attributes are typically represented as floating point variables. Okay, and practically real values can only be measured and represented with limited precision. Okay, so if you see from the theoretical perspective, any of the measurement scale type, which are nominal, ordinal, interval and ratio, could be combined with any of the type, any of this type, based on the number of attributes values. So this the combination can be with either binary, discrete or with continuous. But some combination occur only infrequently and do not make much sense. For example, it is very difficult to think of a realistic data set that contain a continuous binary attribute. So generally nominal and ordinal attributes are binary or discrete, and while interval and ratio attributes are continuous. So you have to remember this very important point. Okay, fine. So next we will see some dissimilarity and similarity measures. Okay, so then we will move on to the basics of similarity and dissimilarity measure. Okay, so first we will start with the similarity measure. So similarity measure between two objects can be defined as a numerical measure of the degree to which the two objects are alike. Okay, so similarities, you can consider similarities are higher for pairs of objects that are more alike. Okay, and similarities are usually non-negative numbers and often fall between 0. 0 means no similarity and 1 means they have the complete similarity. So similarity value always rise between 0 and 1. For example, if I compare two students and I take two objects, student 1 and student 2, if I say that two students are similar, so I can say that two students are similar in terms of their height, in terms of their weight, in terms of their percentage that obtained in a particular semester. Okay, so I can say that the students are similar or the similarity value is 1. Okay, but if the students' weight are not same, height are not same, their academic performances are not same, so I can say that their similarity value is 0. What do you mean by that? That means there is no similarity between the students, and if I say 1, similarity between the two students is 1, so the meaning is that they are completely similar. Fine. So next we will see what is a dissimilarity measure. Okay, dissimilarity measure, in some book you will find it as a distance measure also. So distance and similarity are synonyms. Fine. So the dissimilarity between two objects are defined as a numerical measure of the degree to which the two objects are different. Fine. So dissimilarities are lower for more similar pair of objects. Okay. And frequently the term distance is used as a synonym for dissimilarity measure. Okay. Distance is often used to refer to a special class of dissimilarities. And dissimilarities value generally fall in the interval of 0 and 1, but it is also common for them to have a range from 0 to infinity. So we can say that the value of dissimilarity between two objects, the minimum value is 0, and maximum value in some cases it may be 1, but in some cases upper limit varies, so it may go up to infinity. Okay, so if I want to find out the dissimilarity between two students, and I see that the height and the weight and the academic performance of the two students are not same at all, so I can say that they are dissimilar. Okay, dissimilar means they are dissimilar, so I can give a value which may range between 0 and 1. Okay, or if I say that two students are similar, complete similar, so their value will be 0. Okay, so what I want to say is, if the two students' height, weight and academic performance are same, so I can say that the two students are similar with a similarity value 1, or they are dissimilar with a dissimilarity value 0. Okay, dissimilarity value 0 means they are not dissimilar at all. So they are similar. So there is this relationship between similarity and dissimilarity. Okay, and generally whenever we are using the term called proximity, so generally proximity refers to either similarity or to dissimilarity. Fine. So let's have a look on the table, which will show us the value of dissimilarity and similarity for different objects. So from this particular table, we understand that the attributes may have a different formula for dissimilarity and different formula for similarity. So you have to remember this. Okay, so these are very simple for nominal attribute. So this formula will be taken for nominal attribute. If the two objects are equal, then their dissimilarity value will be 0, and for nominal attribute, if they are not similar at all, their dissimilarity value will be 1. So if the two objects are equal, their similarity value will be 1, and if they are not equal, their similarity value will be 0. For the ordinal attribute also, it is defined, the dissimilarity is defined by using this formula. Okay, where n is the total number of values that an ordinal attribute can take. We will see some example later on. And similarity is getting by subtracting the dissimilarity value from 1. In case of interval ratio scale variable, dissimilarity is the modulus of difference of between the attribute values, and similarity is defined by this following formulas. Okay, so you have to remember this formula and you have to apply this formula. Okay, so in this table where similarity and dissimilarity for various attributes are given, so here x and y are two objects. Okay, two objects means you can consider them to be two students, and they have only one attribute of the indicated type. Suppose we have compared their similarity or dissimilarity value by considering only one attribute, for example academic performance. Okay, this d means the dissimilarity between x and y, and s means similarity between x and y. Okay, so the table summarizes all the formulas that will be applicable for dissimilarity and similarity value for different attributes. So in the next video we will see how this formula can be applied on different types of attributes. Okay, thank you very much.